Welcome to Inside City Hall. I'm your host, Mayor Daryl Seymour, and today on our show we have Steve Beardsley from the White Mountain Mills on Wheels. Welcome, Steve.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you for being here. I appreciate it.
My pleasure.
So share with us a little bit about how you got started with Mills on Wheels and kind of explain what the concept is and how it works.
Well, it's kind of a long way around. Both my wife and I had been involved with a couple different charities in the area, and I was invited one day to join the Meals on Wheels board, which I did, and with the change of the chairman, I got voted to replace him, and been doing it ever since. So it's been a labor of love.
Now, how long have you lived in the area?
About 12 years now.
12 years. Mm-hmm. And what brought you and your wife to Shiloh?
Well, we are both former desert rats, and when we retired, we thought about different places that would be ideal to retire. And of course, coming up here in the summers when we were kids, we were familiar with the area, and we thought this was the place to be.
Oh, great. That's neat that you're here and you want to give back to the community, and we sure appreciate what you do. I know your program helps a lot of people in our community to be able to have food and good quality meals, and kind of share with us the concept of exactly, you know, how it goes about, how many meals you serve, and how many patrons you currently have that you're helping.
Well, our mission is to serve as many homebound senior citizens in the area as we can financially handle. And it's through the efforts of our volunteers and our small staff, actually, the things get done. And I have to give all the credit to them. They basically do all the work. We seek out seniors that are 60 and above who may, for various reasons, be homebound or unable to prepare their own meals. And that number goes up and down with the variation of the clients' personal situations. And we invite all of the folks that may be in need, either financially stressed or having to decide whether they take pills or have a meal, to contact us, and we're going to do everything we possibly can to help their situation.
So is it based on age? You do have to be a certain age, over 60?
That's the prime criteria.
Okay. And then being homebound and unable to possibly prepare a good healthy meal.
Correct. And that may be due to you can no longer reach into a cabinet to grab food, or you may be unable to leave a chair or bed, or there's several different situations that come up in the senior's lifestyle. Our main goal is not just the serving of the meals, it's the wellness of the client.
Okay.
And that involves the interaction with society, because oftentimes seniors find themselves, for whatever reason, alone in their home, no contact during the day, and we seek to solve that problem.
Now, are your meals that you deliver, are they hot already, or do they need to be, you know, warmed up? I mean, while you're talking over here with Susie, Johnny's meal's getting cold sitting in the car. How's that fair? Or do you come see Johnny first the next day?
Well,
and Susie's getting cold.
It's a logistical issue in one way. We are limited by the range we cover by time and temperature.
Okay.
The meal is required to be at a certain temperature when it's delivered to the client. And we use hot boxes to maintain that temperature. We also have cold boxes for foods that require, to be kept cool.
Okay.
We have improved our system a little bit. Actually, we're in the process of waiting for new hot boxes to come in that are heated through the power jacks within the vehicle. So
it will definitely make a difference there. That's good.
Oh, yes.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
How many meals do you serve a day or a week, and usually?
It varies right now between 35 and 45 a day.
Okay.
We serve 5 days a week. If we anticipate bad weather, where something might preclude delivery of a meal on a weekend, we deliver Friday then an extra emergency meal that we call that doesn't require any preparation.
Okay.
A can of soup, peanut butter crackers, something of that sort.
What is the cost associated? You mentioned sometimes there is a financial inability to be able to provide and to have good meals, but what is the cost? Is it the same for each person, or is it based on a person's situation?
No, each meal is the same, $7 a meal. How that is recouped varies depending upon the client's situation. Some are subsidized by ourselves, some are paid for by a family member, some are partly contributed by the client. So there's a variety of financing, if you will, situations available.
That's great. As far as where the meal's prepared, I know a lot of times a person can go down to the senior center and get a lunch. Is that where you prepare most of the meals, in that kitchen there?
All the meals are prepared in the senior center kitchen. Again, we operate under strict regulations as to the quality of the meal, the nutritional value of the meal. It is oftentimes the same meal served within the senior center, although our dining room meals vary because the breadth of the clientele varies. So we try to add a little variety so somebody doesn't get tired of eating the same thing all the time.
Right. And is there a time of day that you usually deliver these meals? Is it usually the noon hour, the evening hour?
The meals are delivered midday. Okay. Usually the volunteers take off somewhere around 10:30 or 11. So the client receives the meal around noon.
Okay. Now the volunteers, they're going out, are they using their own transportation? Is that part of them volunteering, or how does that, work, and how many different volunteers do you have going out?
Well, again, there's a variety of options. We have two vehicles ourselves, one of which was kindly donated by Horn Subaru for our use. But some of the volunteers prefer to use their own vehicles. And if we deem them reliable, then we allow them to use them. We have generally, on average, 10 volunteers. We have three routes. And some volunteers only deliver once a week and others twice a week. And again, it's a very flexible system based upon the needs of the client and the needs of the volunteer.
Oh, that's wonderful. It's neat that we have that many people, giving of their time, giving of their means in some cases to be able to help another person and to be able to get those meals delivered.
I have been overwhelmed by the generosity of the Mountain. Not only the number of volunteers, but contributors that make the donations that allow us to operate. It is phenomenal.
And there. So currently, what would you like to see different or changes going forward? I mean, do you have any grants? Are there any things, it costs a lot of money to you're subsidizing some of these meals already, but how can a person get involved, or how could somebody contribute and help your cause?
Well, many ways. Please contact us at the Sholo Senior Center if you would care to volunteer to deliver meals or help us at some fundraising event. We certainly welcome you. Basically, we're looking for as many clients as possible. We want all the residents of the area to know that we're here to help. And if they feel that they have a need, not only again for the food, but for companionship, some contact with the outside world, please let us know.
How would a person, is it just strictly if they wanted to start receiving meals, would they just as simple as contact the senior center?
Contact the senior center, and then we have an interview process and establish the needs of the client.
Okay. Wonderful. So anything else, Steve, you want to share about what's happening or Anything else that, you know, somebody else needs to know?
Well, there's a constant change going on within the senior center. We're going to be adding some movie nights here as the spring season gets going. I should say afternoon movies. The variety of lunches available is constantly changing, and we invite everyone to come down and have lunch with us.
When is your lunch there at the senior center? What's the times?
11:30 to 12:30. In the summer, it's 5 days a week. Okay. During the winter, it's 4 days a week.
And is it still the $7 to go eat there at the senior center?
Still the $7. And we have different groups that come in during the day playing games, different exercise activities. So it's a terrific facility that the city has furnished to the residents, and we really encourage everybody to come down and enjoy it.
That's fantastic. You know, it is a great to go in. I've had the opportunity of having lunch there several times, and just to see the involvement with people and watching some of the card games that are going on and the different social aspect of it. And I just want to say thank you for what you do and for our citizens who have participated and who help in any way they can to make the Meals on Wheels a success, because I know there's a lot of people that benefit from this great service.
We're very thankful for all of our fellow citizens.
That's great. Well, Steve, thanks for being on our show today, and
welcome
anytime, okay?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank
you. Appreciate
it. Stay tuned for the next segment of Inside City Hall, where we will be talking about the upcoming spring shops and Main Street Farmers Market. Welcome back to Inside City Hall. Now we have Diane North with the Spring Shops and Main Street Farmers Market. Welcome, Diane.
Hey.
Good
afternoon,
you.
I think, yeah.
Yeah, it might be today, who knows.
Yeah.
It's springtime, it's fantastic to have warm weather and see all of the little spring flowers starting to come up and buds. So how you been?
I'm doing great.
Good.
I'm doing great. I'm really excited though.
What are you excited about?
Well, I'm really excited about the market.
Okay.
But we do have a little event coming up in April that we're going to have a special guest at. The Easter Bunny is coming to the shops for April. So if anybody needs a Easter Bunny picture, we're going to have him. He sent me some pictures. Him and his little promoter sent me pictures of him bebopping all around in our little town. Even with the card players, we have a picture of the Easter Bunny with the card players.
The Easter Bunny has been sighted. Huh?
Yes, it has.
That's
yes,
cool.
He has.
That's
so
cool.
I don't know if it's a he or a she, but I guess it's, we always say he, don't we?
It's just the Easter Bunny.
Okay, Easter Bunny.
If you keep it that way, you're okay.
Okay.
All right.
The Easter Bunny has been sighted in downtown Cholo. So
tell me, what are the shops, and tell me a little bit about the farmers markets for some of our listeners who may not know that concept or where they can, you know, go to have some fun.
Okay. So the shops are, it's a spring shop for April, and it's normally after Easter, so we're excited it's before Easter, so that's why the Easter Bunny's coming out. And it's about 30 to 40 local vendors that set up shop over here at the City Campus Gym. We turn it into like a little spring shopping venue, and you just shop. We have a baker that does, Sherry from Bake, she does baked pies and breads and stuff like that. She's always there. We have soaps, we have jams, we have jellies, we have lots of jewelry, paparazzis at this one. We have Robert Ward, who does really nice Christian children's books that a lot of people really are enjoying. And any of my farmers market vendors can come to this too. So okay. We only have 12 spaces left, but we'll have about, I'm going to say 37 vendors in there. And it's a 3-day event. This is the first year we're tempting Sunday, which is a taboo sometimes on the mountain, but we've had enough of the vendors' request for us to make it a 3-day show. So it will be Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We're streamlining the times to be from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. all 3 days, and it's April 12th through 14th.
Okay. Now let's talk a little bit about where the City Gym is. A lot of people aren't familiar with where that's at. So.
That's true. It's a new venue for the city to be utilizing, and I know they have a lot of dinners there, like they sometimes do the Valentine's dance with the father-daughter Valentine's dance, mm-hmm. and stuff like that. But the shops have been doing it, I think this is our third year there. So the City Campus Gym is up on 6th Street and McNeil, where they come together, where the old junior high, a lot of veteran Mountaineers know it as the junior high gymnasium.
Okay.
And the city purchased that whole property, and they're turning that, the gymnasium portion, into a little event center.
It's right next to the new pickleball courts and just...
Yes, which look very nice, by the way.
East of the fire building.
Yes.
That we have downtown Sholo. To the real old people, it's the dome, the old domed, where the old domed gym used to be that we played in elementary school.
Well, that would have been nice, though, if they had left the dome.
On there. Not necessarily. Okay. I'm showing my age, showing the things that we have, but it's much better now.
It's a nice little venue. And I have 47 spaces in there, but a lot of my vendors choose to purchase multiple spaces. So we just try to
get about 40. What are some of the things that, you know, there's all sorts of different shops, different type of thing, but what can we expect to find? You know, are we talking clothing? Are we talking food? Are we talking just all sorts of a mix?
It's a mix. Every year it changes. We do this also in November and December, and they're very, very popular for holiday presents, gifts, decorating and stuff like that. The April shops, this is only our third year doing it because the vendors wanted a spring show kind of before the market starts and all that. So that's why we're giving it to them. And so it's eclectic-y. Some of our vendors that are here in the summer aren't here. They're part-timers like other places, the rest of our mountain is.
Okay.
So, like I said, I know we always have Sherry's baked goods, so people are looking for the pies. We have soaps, goat's milk soaps. We have alpaca stuff. We have books. We have lots of jewelry. There's always wonderful jewelry. There's scrolling. Wood scrolling, where they make beautiful things that you can put out. We have bowls, you name it. This is the shops themselves are the one venue that we don't require them to hand make them. So we'll have the resellers come in with Paparazzi, LuLaRoe, those kind of things. So it kind of gives them a venue as well in our town.
Great.
So yeah, it's a variety.
It sounds like a fun event here leading into spring and part
it
of it.
And it's all about the Easter Bunny this year. I'm so excited.
Well, I heard he has big ears.
He does.
You know, and it's
short nose and big ears.
And, you know, it's important. It's important to get that out. What's going on with Farmers Market a little bit?
The Farmers Market and Art Walk is, this is our 10th year. So we're trying to put it off with a bang. We always start Memorial Day Saturday, which happens to be May 25th this year. And then it goes all the way through September. So there's 19 weeks. Like every 7 years, there's 18, something happens with the calendar. But we always start Memorial Day Saturday and go all the way through September. This year's huge because we actually have a farmer from Marana that has committed to 3 booth spaces with fruits and vegetables grown on his farm. So we're really excited to, it's called Larry's Veggies. They came last year for a month at the end, and we're so excited about our market and what our people needed that they've committed for the whole season. So we will have vegetables and fruits day one.
That's neat.
So that's exciting. Then we have lots more foods coming in. We have Shrimp Ceviche Man, who makes wonderful omelets, green chili burritos. He makes ceviche, which is kind of like, to me, it reminds me of a pico de gallo with shrimp in it. It's very good, though.
A shrimp cocktail all mixed up, and you don't even have to, you know, figure out how.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
Very good point.
That way.
So they've committed. They have 2 spaces. We have a lot of the same vendors, and we have so many more coming in. I just literally had a French baker. Nicole and Maurice are bakers that are French. They're from France. They've been in America for 50 years. They just took me out to lunch, and they brought me this huge sample of what they create of pastries, croissants with sausages in them, croissants with cheese and eggs in them. I have this huge box, and I'm staring at all of it going, wow. And they committed to 2 spaces at
the
market this year.
And you didn't bring that box
today? I brought you guys 5 samples, and I'm sure Mel's not going to tell you a thing about one of those is
Mel
yours.
Mel was sworn to secrecy back there. I see.
So we have, out of 100 spaces, I'm not sure if you know this, we have 100 spaces. We'll never get bigger. We're really proud of the size of our market, and we want the best of Arizona at this market. So I don't want to make it bigger. I don't want more vendors. I want the best vendors. It's right in downtown where our card player statue is. We have 100 spaces and I only have 12 left. We have sold all the others for the entire season. It is so exciting.
What do those spaces run if somebody wanted to get involved with that or if they wanted to get a space here at the shops?
Okay, so the shops are different, and all of it's on our website. So we're really good at keeping the website as up-to-date as possible.
And that website is who? Where?
It's showlowmainstreet.org, because we're a nonprofit organization that focuses on the redevelopment and beautification of downtown Sholo. That's our entire goal. So it's showlowmainstreet.org. Go to the events tab, and then you can do the April shops and see the map and see what's available, or you can go to the Farmers Market and Art Walk and see what's available. The shops, it depends on the location and size of your booth. It goes anywhere from $50 to $75, and that's for the whole weekend. The market is $400 per 10 by 10 space. If you buy multiple spaces, you get 50% off each additional. And if you buy it before May 1st, you get a $50 discount. And that's for the entire season. So it comes out to less than $20 as a booth space.
Right. That's for this season. That's really reasonable to be able to have the exposure and the amount of people. How many people do you think come on a weekend? Have you guys ever got counts kind of hard? But
some of the newer vendors to our mountain market has... they're really good at gauging, and I had one tell me that they think on a very slow day we get minimum of 1,000. On a very fast, heavy packed day, which will be Memorial Day weekend, they're looking at around 3,000. So it's an amazing market. It's so much fun. And Memorial Day Saturday, that May 25th, we'll be open one extra hour. We're normally open from 9 to 1. But on opening day, it's always open 9 to 2, just to kind of give everybody a little extra time. I do know that people will show up as early as 8 to come shopping. But we hate to go past 1 on the regular days, because those monsoon clouds just scare me just a wee bit.
Come on, women would go shopping at 6 a.m. if there was a place open for them.
And some of the vendors do start setting up early, so come on down, see what happens.
And some of the things there, that's neat. Well, we appreciate what you do. We appreciate the Main Street organization. I know you've helped enhance parts of our community, parts of the downtown. Has definitely been beautified by some of the work that you guys have done your crew.
Well, we're really excited about the Wayfinder signs. We've gotten a lot of businesses that have been really thankful for those signs. So we appreciate the city partnering with us with that. And then now we're working on the 9th Street and Cooley, in between the Deuce and Cooley, that little corner, and the city's partnering. You know, the city's a great partner for Sholo Main Street to make things beautiful. We really don't do anything without the city having, some help in it.
That's great.
We appreciate that.
Well, thank you. It was great having you today.
Well, thank you so much. Diane. Have a great day.
Great. Thanks for joining us on Inside City Hall today, and we hope you have a great day. And keep your eyes out for the bunny.
Yes.
Okay.
The Easter bunny.
First one to call in with the sighting of the bunny, I promise I'll get you something worth your while. So give me a call on my cell phone, 242-5998. Thank you.
Very cool.